In the ring at this time, from Hoboken, New Jersey, weighing 235 pounds, Mario Mancini. And his opponent, managed by luscious Johnny Valiant, from parts unknown, weighing 273 pounds, Brutus Beefcake.
And Brutus throws a kiss back to Bond, or to whomever. Luscious Johnny. Oh, there's a look at him. Oh, and to Brute. Give me a break. Luscious Johnny and Brutus Beefcake. There's Beefcake. There's a little stretching, a little warming up.
Pull it back, referee. Pull it back.
And Luscious Johnny preparing Brutus.
You.
Come on. You're out now.
Luscious Johnny himself, quite an accomplished professional wrestler, former tag team champion in the World Wrestling Federation. Luscious Johnny splitting his talents up now in his time between actually participating as a wrestler and managing Brutus Beefcake.
And doing quite well in both areas. He's quite a manager. You know, I think from the first time we saw Beefcake since Valiant became his manager, I think that Beefcake has become much more aggressive than he was. At least I think so.
No doubt about it. Blatant chokehold, risking disqualification for this Beefcake. Drops the knee into the chest, does the Beaver. Luscious Johnny. You can hear his voice. Ooh. Beefcake is unrelenting. I would think Beefcake is going to be disqualified if this continues.
Well, he's following the referee's count. You know, he is breaking at the proper count. But look at this. Mancini's really out of it right now. I doubt if Mancini's got a chance to recoup to try to make any kind of to retaliate in any fashion against Beefcake.
The canvas. You can hear the constant voice of Luscious Johnny. Ooh, give him the whammo, I think Luscious Johnny said. That's exactly what Beefcake gave him. I don't think I've ever seen anyone pin anyone else quite like we just saw Beefcake moments ago.
He really gets up high with that knee, and I mean, he really comes in full force right inside of the jaw.
Here is your winner, Brutus Beefcake.
Fine-looking young athlete.
In the ring at this time, to my right, from Providence, Rhode Island, weighing 230 pounds, Sal G. And his partner from Hoboken, New Jersey, weighing 235 pounds, Mario Mancini. And their opponents are the current World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions. They are being led down the aisle by their manager, Lassie, Fred Lassie. From Tehran, Iran, weighing 258 pounds, the Iron Sheik. And from the Soviet Union, at 313 pounds, Nicolai Volkoff.
Non-final matchup.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Volkoff has requested that you all rise and respect his singing of the Soviet national anthem.
Hello, those who have all this love on,
Volkoff and the Iron Sheik, very proud, of course, of winning the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship, as Sheik displays the championship belt for all to see. One thing we can certainly say for sure, Nicolai Volkoff can wrestle considerably better than he can sing.
Well, you know, we may not like their sing, we may not like their background or whatever, but as far as their nationality, but as far as in the ring, these are two tough men. Volkoff never displays too much wrestling skills, and yet we know the guy can wrestle, but he's such a vicious, vicious man that every time he goes in that ring, he's just brutal. He just wants to annihilate an opponent. On the other hand, the Sheik does display tremendous wrestling skills. I've always said he is the king of the suplexes. Look at this.
Nice takedown, and the Sheik putting the boots. Mario Mancini.
But regardless of their tax, you put these two together and you go, well, you got the champions, but I'll tell you, it'll be a while before somebody dethrones these two.
Back body drop. Uh-oh, look at that. Sheik displaying his physique. And Sheik is just as solid as a block of granite.
Well, I'll tell you, he really is solid. He is so solid. Tough man. Uh-oh, watch this.
Sheik out from one side to the other.
Now that's got to hurt. He had Mancini's neck practically on top of that rope, and then he comes flying with his 250, 60-pound frame right on top of back of his neck.
Mancini now off the rope, and Nicolai gives him a spin in midair with a knee lift to the midsection. Big Nicolai, 330 pounds thereabouts of Nicolai Volkoff. And as you said earlier, you see very little wrestling technique applied by Volkoff, even though he knows it all. He prefers the more brawling tactics.
Yeah, people say, how come if he can, why doesn't he wrestle? He's such a vicious man. Of course he can wrestle. He's a great wrestler. Oh, what's this? Looks like he might do a suplex here. Let's see. There it is.
Yes, indeed.
That's a double chicken wing suplex.
And no doubt the Iron Sheik had something to do with teaching Nicolai Volkoff that particular maneuver.
Perhaps. Ooh, right on that boot. That very controversial boot.
The Iron Sheik back in there with Mario Mancini. Mancini yet to tag his partner. It's been actually two against one.
Yeah, I'd like to see that Sal G come in because I'm not too familiar
with
him.
There we go. Sal G trying to get in there and throw a few right hands, but Volkoff has him off balance way up in the air. Uh-oh. Look at this. Volkoff all the way up and all the way down. And if that was an illegal tag, Sheik was already in the ring.
Uh-oh, suplex.
Oh, my, devastating maneuver.
And you know what's coming up now. Here it is.
Sheik now getting ready to apply the camel clutch. And Sal G in a most compromising position and finally giving up. Oh. The Iron Sheik with Mancini through the ropes and outside. They're not finished with Sal G yet. Outside as well. Inside, Freddie Blassie and the tag team champions. Enjoy it while you can, gentlemen.
Here are your winners, the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, the Iron Sheik and Nicolai Volkoff. To my right in the ring, from Hoboken, New Jersey, weighing 235 pounds, Mario Mancini. And his opponent, to be led down the aisle by his manager, Elizabeth, from Sarasota, Florida, weighing 235 pounds, Randy Macho Man Savage.
The Macho Man, as he strolls into the ring, to the tune of pomp and circumstances, Look at that robe of the Macho Man. But let's look at Elizabeth. Elizabeth is one of the sweetest ladies I've had the pleasure of chatting with ever so briefly, I might add, on a recent TNT.
A pretty lady.
Oh, she is. And just as nice. I don't know what in the world she sees in the Macho Man. I can't imagine.
I'm still very confused about that. Why she's managing this guy, what experience, managerial experience she's had in the past. I still don't know too much about Elizabeth. Do you know her background as far as wrestling, what she's done, or...
Not really a heck of a lot. I do know that she really admires the Macho Man and does from time to time at least attempt to give him advice. I'm not too sure that he always listens to it, but I think she's, I don't know, well, a manager of a different kind. But that's what you would expect with a Macho Man. He's so unique himself.
Well, I've been trying to ask a lot of questions, trying to find out a little bit about Elizabeth. What I did hear about her, why the Macho Man is so hep on her, is because I hear she's a very tough negotiator as far as getting him the proper matches, proper contracts, proper monies. I hear she's a very, very shrewd lady in that sense. But I really don't know anything about what background that she got as far as knowledge in wrestling itself to help him as far as helping him as a wrestler.
Well, maybe the Macho Man thought that that's what he needed. Maybe he doesn't think, oh, look at that, that he really needs to help in the technique department. Maybe he thinks he needs to help, as you brought out, more of the contractual outside standpoint. Look at that.
Perhaps. Did you see that maneuver he just did?
Uh-oh, look at this.
Uh-oh, see what he's going to do now.
Boom. Ah. Macho Man uses the top ropes. Mancini to the outside, almost landed on his feet.
And look at this. There he goes now. Look, here's the Macho Man on the top rope. Watch, he'll come down all the way on the floor.
Ooh,
boom.
Oh, that takes unbelievable coordination and agility to do that.
Well, you better believe it.
Mancini hurled back into the ring. A good look at Elizabeth. Likes what she sees at the moment, I would think. She is really in awe of the Macho Man, Randy Savage.
Look at this. I believe this week comes down with that elbow smash. That is so devastating. I've never seen anybody do this like the Macho Man.
Boom. That could very well spell defeat for Mancini. It does indeed. The Macho Man, Randy Savage, asking Elizabeth. You know, he never holds the ropes for Elizabeth. When never helps her into the ring at all.
No, he actually...
Your winner, Randy Macho Man Savage.
Come on now.
Introducing first, to my left, the manager, the mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart. He represents from Seattle, Washington, weighing 248 pounds, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, Bret the Hammer Valentine. His opponent from Hoboken, New Jersey, weighing 235 pounds, Mario Mancini.
Mario Mancini to meet one of the veterans in the WWF, and certainly Mr. Valentine regarded as, I would suspect, one of the greats as well in many, many respects. Oh my goodness, gentlemen almost looked like the animal there. Not the lady, but someone next to the lady. Valentine locking up with Mancini, shoves him to the buckle. Not where you want to be with a Greg Valentine. Series of shoulder blocks as referee Rita Marie tries to usher Mr. Valentine out of the corner.
Valentine may not have a lot of fans, but I'll tell you what, you know, in the wrestling game, all his peers, they all have great respect for the way that he keeps himself in such tremendous shape. And I'll tell you, he's held that title. Oh, here comes a suplex.
Yes, indeed. Nicely executed as Jimmy Hart leaps for joy moments ago.
He has held that title for a while now, and the way he's going and the shape he keeps himself in and the determination that he has, looks like he's going to keep that title for some time to come.
But certainly the competition, if anything, gets tougher and tougher for Mr. Valentine. As time goes on, there are so many that would like very much to have the opportunity to wrestle Mr. Valentine for the title.
And he's well aware of the stiff competition. I believe that that's why he is keeping that aggressive attitude, always in tip-top shape, because he knows he's got a lot of competition there. And thus far, he's doing quite well for himself against all comers.
Come on, Hammer, stay on him, baby. Stay on him.
The mouth of the South, they sure named him right.
That's for sure. But poor Mancini thus far has not had a chance to do anything other than just take a lot of, absorb a lot of punishment from Valentine. Well, now Tommy's already going for that. Well, he starts working on that leg. Usually when he goes after the leg, he's got one thing in mind, and that's for that figure from the leg lock. Mancini's expressing the pain he is getting. Whoa, look at that big elbow right on the middle of that thigh. See, he keeps after it. When Valentine gets you hurt, whether it's the arm or the leg, usually it's the leg because he keeps going. Well, right now he's going for that one, I thought he was going to go for the one-legged crab. But usually he stays on it. He likes to keep working it, and then usually he'll always wind up with that figure for a leg lock.
This is not a pinning combination. But Mr. Valentine can make you wish you were not in the ring on many an occasion. Valentine, and oh, look at this now. Mancini in a most compromising position. Nicely done.
You know, what you said a second ago was the pinning situation, and it wasn't, but he was torturing that leg, keep weakening that leg. Uh-oh, what's he going to do here? And there it is. Here comes the figure four leg lock.
Valentine cinching it up now, and Mario Mancini wasting no time. Mancini trying to hold out, but can't hold out for long. Jimmy Hart right in the ring, clapping, and oh, look at Valentine. Just now releasing the hold. Jimmy Hart leaping for joy. Greg the Hammer Valentine, look at that kisser. What a determined athlete this man is.
Here is the winner, the Intercontinental Champion, Greg the Hammer Valentine. In the ring at this time from Hoboken, New Jersey, weighing 235 pounds, Mario Mancini. His partner from Owings Mills, Maryland, weighing 255 pounds, Mike Rice. And their opponents to be led down the aisle by Elizabeth from San Diego, California, weighing 271 pounds.
All right.
Jesse the Body Ventura. And his partner from Sarasota, Florida, weighing 235 pounds.
The way that the Macho Man treats his manager, Elizabeth. There, the Body, Jesse Ventura. Ventura and the Macho Man. Quite a colorful tag team combination, to say the least. However, I beg to differ with your view earlier on, Bruno. Do you feel this is going to be... Oh, no, what's he doing? Watch out, look at him. Like he's yelling at her.
I think he is.
Poor little thing, look at her. Look at her, she's got her head down. She's about ready to cry.
I think so, I do. Whatever he told her, I think it really hurt her feelings bad. No, he's still calling her off.
Macho Man Randy Savage and his partner Jesse Ventura would be quite a combination. Physically, yes, I agree with you, but I just think that you have these two enormous egos in Ventura and in the Macho Man, Randy Savage. I think they'll be so selfish in there, and that's something you can't be in a good tag team combination.
Well, that could be, but I've seen Ventura at different times speak of the Macho Man, and he really praised him. He sounds like he really, really admires the Macho Man, and the Macho Man, in turn, has also paid similar compliments to the body of Ventura. So I'm going by that, and as far as their ability goes, we know what tremendous ability they have. So they put all their assets together in that ring. That's why I'm saying that they should make a fantastic team.
Well, thus far, we have seen frequent tags, which would lead one to believe that indeed they are not going to be selfish and function as a unit. What's he saying? Boy, he was really putting a bad mouth on Elizabeth. Macho Man, ooh, kicking it back of the head. Oof. Macho Man and Jesse Ventura thus far in complete control, and coming in the ring the hard way is Mike Rice. Right into the buckle, tag is made, and again Ventura comes in. So we see those frequent tags.
Yes.
Which indicates again, as we stated before, that we are not going to see a selfish combination.
Now, like I say, I've seen from listening to these two talk in the past, they compliment each other an awful lot. They both seem to have an enormous amount of respect for one another. That's why, you know, I kind of thought that together, if they do put all their assets together with the abilities that they both have, look at this here. Nobody does this much better than Macho as far as coming off these top ropes into the ring or outside the ring.
Oh, God. Elbow right to goodness. The chest area. That could very well spell defeat. And it does, yes.
And look at Ventura. He looks thrilled. He's happy.
I think he's looking at you, Bruno.
He's always irritating me like this, this guy.
Little kiss, little buzz on the cheek there from Elizabeth to the Macho Man. Although she doesn't look all that happy.
No, she does not.
Here are the winners, the team of Jesse, the Body Ventura, and Randy Macho Man Savage. Ring at this time from Hoboken, New Jersey, weighing 235 pounds, Mario Mancini. And his opponent, led down the aisle by his manager, the Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart, from Atlantic City, New Jersey, weighing 458 pounds. Bundy!
Oh my goodness. Now there have been in the past, and certainly currently are, some awesome forces in the World Wrestling Federation, but that's the word for this man. He is awesome.
He most definitely is. You know, Vince McMahon, I really believe you could set King Kong Bundy up as the West screen of the drive-in movies. And they could show a film on his back. Check out that man's back.
Huge, huge man. King Kong Bundy with Mario Mancini.
And this, in my honest opinion, is a mismatch.
Oh, I think there's no doubt about that. Off the rope, my goodness, the elbow knocks Mancini down, and Jimmy Hart is delighted. Yes, indeed, Jimmy Hart hopes to bring King Kong all the way to the top. Look at this, two, and I think Bundy could have had three.
He definitely could have had three if he wanted it, but King Kong Bundy is the only wrestler I know in the world. He don't want nothing to do with a 3 count. He wants a 5 count. A 5 count. Unheard of in wrestling.
Again, we remind our fans and friends of the Reading, Massachusetts area that tonight at 8 p.m. it's World Wrestling Federation action at the Reading High School. No doubt in everyone's mind that Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, surrounded by controversy, clouded by many problems, or perhaps Mr. Wonderful tonight will be ready than he's ever been before when he has his matchup at the Reading High School gym.
King Kong Bundy destroying thus far Mario Mancini. The referee must be thinking about stopping this match. This is a totally lopsided affair.
I'll tell you, I'm impressed with King Kong Bundy, and it takes a lot to impress Jesse the Body Ventura.
Some of the fans are about ringside yelling, ding dong. It's not ding dong, it's King Kong. And one person you could ask right now that's a believer, at least thus far he's a believer, is Mario Mancini.
Without a doubt, King Kong Bundy is doing just what he pleases with Mario Mancini. Mancini's showing no offense whatsoever. It's been all King Kong Bundy from the opening bell.
King Kong Bundy looks like a bus in there. He's just huge. Mancini to the puck. Look out! Oh, my goodness!
As Don Meredith would say, turn out the lights. The party's over.
Look out! With an elbow! Oh, my goodness! Three, four, and then in five. Look at that. Jimmy Hart leaping into the arms of King Kong Bundy. That's King Kong.
Here is your winner, King Kong Bundy. Introducing first in the corner to my right, from Hoboken, New Jersey, weighing 235 pounds, Mario Mancini. His opponent will be led towards the ring by his manager, Freddie Blassie. And here he is from Tampa, Florida, weighing 265 pounds, Hercules Hernandez.
Bruno, what do you know about Hercules Hernandez?
Well, I'll tell you what. I've heard part of it. First of all, he's a very strong man. He's a very big guy. As we've just heard, 265 pounds. But also, I hear he's a very vicious man. But he has been extremely successful, not only through different parts of the United States, but overseas as well. He's got quite a reputation for himself, and now we will get to see just, you know, if everything said about him is true.
In upcoming weeks here on TV, we'll give you complete details as to who will be appearing on the World Wrestling Federation Mat Spectacular, a holiday spectacular to boot, at the Providence Civic Center Thursday, December 26th. Get your tickets in advance. Wrestling tickets make great Christmas gifts. Surprise someone. You know surprises will be happening, especially when the Junkyard Dog takes on Terry Funk at the Providence Civic Center Thursday night, December 26th.
You can bet that there's been an awful lot of coaching and schooling that has taken place on the part of manager Freddie Blassie. Before, oh my goodness, we don't do that in the WWF. Hernandez posing for this capacity crowd. I don't think all that many are, well, you have to be impressed, but...
Well, he is an impressive-looking man, Look at that. He's, you know, he takes Mancini like he's a real featherweight. You can see he's a very, very strong man. We can also see he's a very mean individual.
Well, this man is cast right out of the mold of the Fred Blassie doctrine of wrestling. Look at the Fred Blassie certainly appreciating the talents of Hercules Hernandez.
Bragging about his big arms, and they are big, aren't they?
Yes, but so many times, it's as we have seen, it's not how large they are, really, or even how strong. It's what you can do with them in the ring and in conjunction with all the other body parts and make things work.
Well, so far, in an illegal sense, of course, with his tactics, but so far he's got those parts working very well for himself.
Yes, he does.
Because Mancini has provided no opposition to him, no competition to form at all.
Scoops up a Mancini. The knee driving it down in the lower back area. What's this?
Backbreaker.
Gets him right up there. Holds him up there. Lets him think about it. Big, strong man like that can really do some damage to the back. Oh,
Boy, look at that. Wow. The way he just dropped him off like that, huh?
That's not exactly the kind of face you'd want to take home to meet your sister, that's for sure. Let's get
Here's
the official
your
report.
Winner, Hercules Hernandez.
Hercules Hernandez.
In the ring at this time, to my right, from Hoboken, New Jersey, weighing 235 pounds, Mario Mancini. His partner, weighing 235 pounds, Paul Roma. And their opponents, led down the aisle by Jimmy Hart, the Mouth of the South, and Lusus John Vaggett, the tag team comprised of, from San Francisco, California, weighing 273 pounds, Brutus Beefcake. And his partner from Seattle, Washington, weighing 248 pounds, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, Greg the Hammer Valentine.
Greg Valentine and Brutus Beefcake. Needs a transplant? Well, he might if he's going to have a heart with any sympathy. Johnny Valiant. Along with Jimmy Hart, the brains behind the brawn of Brutus Beefcake and Greg the Hammer Valentine. Brutus now residing in San Francisco, California. Last minute words of advice. And Greg Valentine will start things off for his team. Likewise will be Paul Roma. Uh-oh, Fruitcake, you hear some of the chants. Valentine drives the knee to the spine area. That'll take its toll early on.
Oof, this Paul Roma's a fine-looking athlete. He usually does give most of his opponents a pretty good go at it, but now we'll see what he can do against Greg Valentine and Beefcake. Although both of them together, wow, what a shot right in that buckle. That was a good move. Beefcake went to slam him. He stepped out on him, took the leverage away. But Beefcake came over and flipped into that mat to give him a shot anyway.
Beefcake, front face lock. Takes over Roma. Hooks a leg, he may get him. Two! No, can't quite hold on. And Roma making his way over, driving the shoulder. Roma, I would suspect, should make, finally does, makes a tag. Mancini and now the legal man in the ring. Tries to haul him out. Oh, look at that right hand by Beefcake.
That was a bad move. He tried to peel him out of that corner. What for? You got him in there. Roma's right outside. Try to do something. We can keep it. Oh, what's that? I should have tried to keep him in that corner. Instead, he's trying to peel him across the ring. That was lack of experience.
Valentine drops the hammer. Mancini in the air. Only one place to go, and that'll be down the shoulder breaker. Beefcake looking on. I'm not too sure whether or not they could have had the count. I guess we'll never know.
For sure.
Wide open Mancini as Beefcake goes downstairs.
What a shot, right? The solar plexus. Well, again, see, it's lack of experience because Mancini made that bad move when he tried to look at Beefcake.
Strutting about the ring. He's something.
Yeah.
Ooh.
You can't make mistakes when you're in there with the likes of Beefcake and Greg Valentine. These are two tough, tough individuals. When you put them together, you got a tough combination. Yeah, look at Mancini. Came to life there.
Yes, but a wreck in the face turns things right back around. Just the way Beefcake likes him. Tag made Valentine now. The head of steam and drops the knee into the midsection.
Now we're
That's a good front face lock. He front face locks, but he hooks the arm at the same time of Mancini. Ooh,
look at that.
Roma wasn't expecting it.
That's one way to keep your partner from tagging.
Uh-oh, here comes a suplex.
Driving a suplex. Frequent tag is now Beefcake back through, and it looks like Mancini's going to make the tag to Roma. No, not quite. Did he make it?
No, he did not. Just missed it.
Valentine and Beefcake doing a good job of keeping Mancini away from tagging his partner, Paul Roma. Oh, my.
Well, you know, that's it.
Valentine off the rope, drops the elbow.
Teamwork.
Valentine dragging Mancini like he's a carcass of some kind out to the middle of the ring. Snapping the hams, and now Valentine spinning toe hold, going for the figure four leg lock, and sinks it in. That should be all she wrote. Valentine, the master of the figure four leg lock, once again proves his superiority, while Roma helping out a little bit, helping Mancini, his partner, out, but not helping enough, however, and it'll go down in the record book as a victory for the rather unusual but certainly successful combination of Greg Valentine and Brutus Beefcake.
Here are your winners, the team of Greg the Hammer Valentine and Brutus Beefcake. To my right, from Hoboken, New Jersey, at 235 pounds, Mario Mancini. And his opponent, from the Double Cross Ranch in Amarillo, Texas, weighing 260 pounds, Terry Funk.
This is one mean hombre in there. Terry Funk, one of the baddest dudes ever from the Lone Star State. Funk recently fined $5,000 for manhandling ring attendant Mel Phillips, whom, by the way, we are told is going to return to active duty, so to speak, next week. And he has really had a rough time of it. He was just pummeled by Terry Funk for no good reason.
Well, I hope it taught Terry Funk a lesson at $5,000, because what he did certainly was uncalled for, and he deserved that fine, and we'll see what happens. Oh, look at this. The ultimate insult, to slap an opponent in the face. But that's Terry Funk. He'll slap you, he'll bite you, he'll kick you, he'll do everything.
Shoulder block by Mr. Funk. Trying it again over Mancini. Oh, almost over.
Oh, they ever come close. He's coming with such force, you're trying to tackle Mancini. Mancini ducked him. He just went flying over the top rope. He just barely caught himself.
Mancini to the ropes, and Terry Funk. Ooh, my. Southpaw Funk laying it in there. Another one.
He is mean as they come. Like I say, I've known quite a few wrestlers to come out of Texas. I don't know if I've ever seen anybody. Oh, Hankman. I don't know if I've ever seen anybody quite as mean as Terry Funk. He is extremely mean and vicious.
Terry Funk setting up Mancini. And two. Good job.
Whoa, he kicked out.
Uh-oh, what's he doing now? Off the rope. Ooh, what? Funk on the back of Mario Mancini. This is vintage Terry Funk. Here he goes again now. Off the rope. Oh, my, missing there. Mancini has Funk all in the rope there. And Terry Funk, oh, my. On the outside, now making his way back on the inside, meeting him, Mario Mancini. Hasn't been a side headlock. Funk shoves him to the ropes, trying to set him up, and ooh, my!
Ooh.
Sidestepped him.
Yeah, he just sidestepped him. He grabbed Mancini in the back of the neck and shot him right out the, at that ring. What's he called him? A pig?
Oh, wow. Kicked it out. Mancini, big setup suplex now, and holding him up there for a while, down to the canvas. Terry Funk winding up Mario Mancini, and that could very well spell the end of it right there. Submission hold by Terry Funk. Yes, indeed. Come on, let it go. Buck risking another fine as Terry Funk takes the Duke.
Introducing first to my right, from Hoboken, New Jersey, weighing 235 pounds, Mario Mancini. His partner from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing 238 pounds, SD Special Delivery Jones. Their opponents, first of all, introducing the manager, Jimmy Hart. And he represents, from Calgary, Alberta, Canada, weighing 231 pounds, Bret Hart. And from Reno, Nevada, at 280 pounds, Jim the Anvil Neidhart.
Jim the Anvil Neidhart doing a little popcorn there about the ringside. Jim the Anvil Neidhart and Bret Hart teaming up. SD now locking up with Neidhart, who's one of the stronger individuals in the World Wrestling Federation. Big, powerful man.
And you know, SD Jones is no slouch either on the strength department. So look at that. Look at that Neidhart. He pushes Jones away like if he were nothing.
SD locking up again. A little shove back. And SD exhibits he has a little power in his own right. Aha, getting behind him quickly, SD. Nice reversal.
Another reminder about the great WWF card on its way to Lowell, Massachusetts, 1 week from this Tuesday night on April 30th at the Lowell Memorial Auditorium. We did mention King Kong Bundy. We'll also tell you that on the card, SD Special Delivery Jones, Greg the Hammer Valentine, Brutus Beefcake, and a whole host more coming to Lowell at the Lowell Memorial Auditorium on Tuesday, April 30th.
Ooh. The Anvil, Jim Neidhart, with a tag now to Bret Hart. Drop kick, my goodness. Off the rope now, and Bret Hart lifts the knee. And then what a kick to the head that was.
Is that a headbutt? Wow. Boy, Ed Mancini's really taking a shellacking.
Right. Into the foot of Neidhart, tag is made. Whip to the rope, Mancini coming off now. Shoulder of big Jim Neidhart. Oh, come on now, ref. Referee should take control of this matchup. Ooh. The Anvil in now. Look at that. Jimmy Hart closing him out in the ring. Horsefly like. Stirring up all sorts of things. Up in the air, and what's going to happen here? Oh, my! What a clothesline from way up high. And an easy three count. So there, the Anvil, Jim Neidhart, stepping into the ring, and he and Bret Hart have demolished Mario Mancini. We'll get the official decision.
Here are your winners, the team of Bret Hart and Jim the Anvil Neidhart.